The thing that drives researchers, particularly in academia, more than anything else, is they want to be able to compete. They want to be the first one on the planet to discover and to invent.
We understand that in order to do that, we have to have a top 10 research computing structure on this campus that our faculty and our students can access whenever they need it.
Inspiration doesn't favor those who sit still. UF's information technology units have been busy upgrading network speeds throughout the entire campus. The Research Computing Center needed to be big enough and powerful enough to handle some of the most complex computation the world has ever seen. So they thought big, really big, to accommodate university computing needs for the next decade. The Research supercomputer boasts nearly 24,000 cores and is affectionately known as HiPerGator. It's the fastest among universities in Florida and top 10 in the country.
HPC provides us with enormous facilities that we would not be able to commandeer so easily.
UF professor Paul Avery is part of a worldwide team that discovered the Higgs particle at the CERN laboratory in Geneva, Switzerland.
We could have, of course, tried to get our computing done in other facilities around the world, but it would take us for a far longer period of time because we wouldn't have the priority or the ability to even learn how to run it at those centers. And so by having the resources actually located here at the University of Florida, we can actually get things done on a much faster time scale. And timing is everything.
So, who makes innovation possible? It's people who pursue challenge with a passion, working to impact every moment of every day.
Interdisciplinary research is really a flourishing enterprise on the University of Florida campus, and it is an aspect of the campus that enables us to be tremendously successful and helps us to drive the cutting edge.
It's an institution that drives for excellence, and only going to be satisfied when we are where we need to be, and that is top 10 in the country.
And you're challenged to go further, to provide really bright people with the tools they need to compete with anyone on the planet. And what researcher doesn't want to be a part of that kind of environment?